Sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. Everything that's wonderful is what I feel when we're together. Brighter than a lucky penny. When the rain goes, disappears near, and I feel so fine. Just to know that you are mine. My life is sunshine, lollipops, and rainbows. That's how this refrain goes. So come on, join in.
Everybody. Nice.
Wait, I think I have a boat. Alright, guys, let's go, let's go, let's go! Everybody rush, everybody rush! So for the open qualifiers, our main goal is advancements, which is basically kills, getting coins, and
yes,
doing everything. Oh, I'm going.
Don't worry, even I'm distracting. Hopefully. Maybe. Dang it. No.
Dude, Bizzo did 6 hearts of damage with a bow. I'm getting 2 shot.
Nine.
One's behind you guys.
I got a pickaxe. I think my pickaxe just disappeared. Wait, I'm so
okay,
confused.
Nice. E-girl down. W. It's a Tommy Innit reference. Go, go, get it.
My diamond pick is gone.
Yes! This was my first match ever playing this game mode, which is why nothing really happened and why this footage is condensed down so much.
Okay, there's a
man, I have a totem.
Things might be a little confusing objective-wise, so I'll briefly touch upon that. And even though I had impact kills, I just killed Bizzle again! I didn't have enough kills to secure our team our win. In Beaconators, there's 2 teams, the attackers and the defenders. The defenders have to defend the beacon against the attackers, and when the attackers break it, then they move on to the next beacon. Sounds simple enough? Well, pretty much because it is. It's also the same as that one Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare game mode that we all played growing up. There's also a shop though, which complicates things a little bit, so I didn't include it in the video, but I thought I'd mention it if you see a little imbalance in loot.
Meow.
Yo, who just meowed?
And...
what a weirdo.
I think we just banned them on the spot.
Who did that?
Automatic disqualification.
Oh god.
Automatic, yeah, for real.
Get him out of here. Who was that? Because not much else happened in the open qualifiers, and because it was based on advancements, not kills, I'll just be showing the results.
Here are the final results. Llama, 25 out of 78. Vivern, 28 out of 78. Demon PK, 21 out of 78. Archul.
Stop interrupting. Oh my
god. Tying in first.
Bro, what a tryhard.
I tied with 2 others, and because they were both beta testers, I had to submit some more results.
I'm playing Minecraft inside of my mother.
1K.
Excuse
me?
With 1 small drag and a mouse click, I would soon become the best Beaconators player in the server. All I would have to do is send it into the statistics channel.
The editing going on in the statistics channel?
I don't think that's happening.
You know, look at the latest post in there. Yeah,
I think he's just really
legit, you know? Very legit right there.
Bro is so good.
Bro is cracked.
Alright, Archul. Alright, Archul. Get rid of it.
What?
You've done your trolling. You've done your trolling.
No, Archul's just a W, bro.
Archul is
throwing
the sauce. I don't think we can stop him. He's on different.
I don't think we can beat. I think Archul should just get the prize money now.
Exactly.
From here on out, I'm giving everyone op.
With op, I just de-opt everyone and ban them all so they wouldn't have an opportunity to, like, learn about the map or do anything interesting.
Alright, I unbanned everyone.
I'm just gonna stop the server. They started opping everyone again through console. Because day 1 of the tournament ended, everybody started to get some sleep for day 2. Except me. Because I would spend the next 4 or 5 hours learning everything about the map. I learned anything from how to consistently do barrier parkour using boats to be able to get 1/7 of an advancement to being able to unlock some pretty powerful weapons hidden underground. Chip and I even figured out how to use boats to clip into a rare event room to press a secret button to get loads of money to get better items for PvP. After a good night's sleep, I'd practice the game mode and some of its secrets with viewers from my Discord. So you should join my Discord if you ever want to get put in a video, link in description. Alright, 2v3.
Dum dum.
She adds.
No,
no, that's me.
Look how fast I am. I can't control my hits. I'm so fast.
They're gonna break beacon. But we still have to.
I'm 1v3.
That speed sucks for Wolf.
Dude, my FOV was crazy too.
I also joined the practice round that the event host started. Can I go back? Like, I'm gonna just punch him off, watch. I killed him. It was mainly just a lot of me trolling and watching. I was watching to see if anyone else decided to learn secrets, and so far, nobody did.
Only the first and second of this segment will move forward to the end of year.
Because only the top two killers would move on, and I'd be competing against only a squid, I'd have to be efficient at implementing my secrets.
Yeah, I have enough already. I have enough. I'm going back. I'm upgrading the shop. Or the mine already. Okay, we have a mine.
Wait, already? Wait, how?
I'm telling you, dude. I got the strats. Don't worry about it. I bought the mines early to press this button and go in the passage that's hidden in the mine. Then I'd go in this open room at this huge fortress, and behind it, after doing a little bit of parkour, I'd have to do this one hard jump, which I missed. And I missed again, and somebody else did it before me. But it's fine, because they shared, and I got some pretty powerful weapons. Wait, I don't want anyone to kill this. Wait, who wants something? Yo, Viv, want this?
Here you go. Oh, thank you. What is this?
I don't know. Because of my items added invisibility, I would just wait for people to pass me, then kill them. Focus on a beacon? Okay. There's somebody flanking behind, like fully behind. This is why my reign of terror starts to fall. Ember's like fully behind. Oh, they're getting the checkpoint. Wait, did we lose the beacon or something? I'm lagging.
Alicia early game is just harassing me.
Although to most, this may seem like a simple kill after getting pushed up against the barrier, but the event organizer thought I was hacking.
So are you using axes, Ember?
Guys, come back to beacon, come back to beacon.
Archer, look in chat, look at Archer.
Of course. She said, well, why?
Oh my god.
Say you want the money. Yeah, say it!
I'm being peer pressured. Hacking is banned. Let's say my bad.
Wait, let me go, let me address it. Archer, are you actually using hacks, though? Because...
No, he's not.
Are you sure?
He is.
No, I downloaded 1.15.2 worse.
You should automatically disqualify him.
Yeah, that's the hacking.
I'll accept that if Vivern also gets disqualified.
What?
I have my POV if you want to look at it, Ember.
Hacking.
You can look at my POV after. I'm recording.
Okay, alright. Alrighty.
Guys, I'm not recording. I lied. Oh, there's like two people there.
Oh, how did they kill me?
Does your elytra give you defense?
Not really.
Oh shoot.
There's different types of elytra.
It's half broken, but it's... I've used it so well. Killed everybody.
Is this spawn camping? I'm just bullying Ember. I don't feel bad, because I got hackusated. Yeah, I have her, like, really distracted. This isn't the play. I'm gonna let her get them. Breaking. There's two breaking.
Should we just let them break?
No.
Breaking. Oh, they got it. That's fine.
So what, they finally got the beacon. We still have plenty more to defend, right? Here, Squid, take this shield. It's really good.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wait, isn't this the one that makes me really weak?
Maybe.
Guys.
It broke again? Oh my god.
With our second beacon broken, we would have to do our best to defend the rest.
What?
The strikers won? How'd they win?
They skipped the fourth objective entirely and then broke the fifth one. Don't ask me how that's possible. Maybe it had something to do with Ember running early, but I have no idea. Or worse.
Wait, what? Did they just run the whole map?
The water beacon wasn't broken.
Yeah, wait, what?
Even though we lost, I was still doing good for kills. Surprisingly, I was contested again for game 2. But just wait till game 3, cause on attackers, I have a really strong secret that nobody knew about. Chest if you don't loot the chest.
People learned it from me.
I figured it out on my own.
I doubt that. Nobody knew how to do this yesterday, and then as soon as I learned how, it's like... Yikes. Oh my gosh, what am I falling on?
Alright, I got it. I'll wait for you. Would I really keep my end of the deal and wait for them? I love things. And things were in the chest, just waiting for me. I was mocked for not figuring it out on my own, when I did. Well, if you count using worst to find secrets around the map. Secrets that you heard about via year-old YouTube video description that briefly mentions it. Well, with the chest tempting me, I opened it, I just took everything. Oh my god, there's 4 Earth Shatterers! Earth Shatterers effectively one-tap anyone.
We're not allowed to have them.
No, we are. It's not purple.
What's the OP item? Any OP item is labeled purple. So any purple item is disabled or banned, basically.
But we're not allowed to have it.
I don't know, man. It's not purple.
We are not allowed to have it.
I don't know, man. It's not purple.
We aren't allowed to have it, bro.
Okay. Yeah. Purple, bro.
I see the color yellow, personally. I'm pretty sure she said purple like 5 times.
Bro, we aren't allowed to.
I just got a frag with it.
This.
Oh my god, bro. Relax. Stop melding.
We aren't allowed to have this. God dang. Y'all are gonna die. Someone's
breaking it. I just dropped it in spawn somewhere. Right. Oh.
Oh my god, be quiet. You're so annoying.
Soon, we had to defend the 5th beacon because I only had 5 kills from spending most of the game doing literally nothing. So I had to clutch up. What is that? Why am I getting sent to Mars?
Why am I blinded?
What? I was at... Oh my god. I was at Y400, I'm dead. This player I'm killing is offhanding a purple item, which is why they don't die. Don't ask me why they can break already made rules, but when I use specific items, new rules are made to nerf me.
What? So what happened?
I killed her.
Oh my god, this river is so laggy with all of these magnets.
Just, you know, keep that in mind.
Oh, this tornado is like, it's just, oh, it's just chasing the tornado.
Sorry to interrupt this.
What? They broke it after!
Squid had one more kill than me, I wanna die. Game 3 is the final game, and I finally get to play as a striker. The main strategy I go for is to loot these 2 chests by the mine early. And even though I don't need the shop for any secrets, it's just for team progression.
They're on the beacon! Oh wait, are we attacking or defending? I forgot.
Glad to have you on my team. Because of this, I'm able to buy a sword and almost full armor in less than a minute into the game. And because our team was so fast at breaking the first beacon, when I finally got into the fight, I was able to fight all the defenders from behind because our spawn point moved.
Go. Someone go for the, what's it called, checkpoint.
We invent for rushing in, someone go for checkpoint.
Yeah, Helix, go for it.
Before even attacking the second beacon, I begin to loot this entire underground area, which has plenty of riches.
Wait for us.
Or vaporize, I know you... Back.
Carter has all the ping.
12 deadly rockets.
12? Okay, I'm here.
Soon enough, we got the beacon.
Yes! Go! Let's go!
I was involved. Got one. Nice. Girl power, let's get him.
Oh, get the bone guy. After him, we can get beacon. Get it.
I'm getting it. Thank you.
Get it. Hurry up. Let's go.
I can't break any faster. I don't have a keybind for my fast break hack. Come on. Yo, boat. Who wants a boat? Anyone? Here, you can drive. I'm going to go and see if they... Yeah, I'm still here.
I've got a drafting bone, so I'm just going
to
go.
Any purple item is disabled.
Me.
No. I'm not going to give it to you. Wait, sorry, Chad, I can't reach out. in a tournament and my teammates are going to scream at me.
A pretty heavy stagnation would take place. We were finding it hard to make impact, and I was finding it hard to not get 2v1. So on a boat? Turn up. Oh, what the hell is that creature? What the hell? That was just rude. I'm going to throw my poison pots. Okay, we should probably do a coordinated push, yeah? Get like mobs and stuff. We should say at 14 minutes we all push, yeah.
Go, everyone push.
They're pushing mid. Pushing. Yeah, they pushed mid.
Okay, I'm going in. I'm dead. My helmet broke.
Yeah, this is a yikes. Alright, cue the sad music again. Our big push failed and we spent almost half of our time on this one objective. But that's where a little trick I discovered will come in handy. Do you really think this is a waste of time compared to stuff we've seen? Imagine I pull up with that. They have scythes, Fatal Elytra, plus 36% armor. I'm staying up all night. I'm staying up all night. There were a couple of issues, one being this gate that would be opened after you completed some pretty simple parkour, but beating the parkour didn't do anything, so we decided to just use a boat to clip through. This would be great, but we didn't know how to open the door to get into the hidden room. We soon found a small item sorter nearby, but you need to put in a dirt.
How do you get a dirt?
To skip ahead, after an hour of looking and Chip falling asleep, I found a random button that gave me dirt. Oh my god, Chip, are you here? Chip? Hello? After this accomplishment, I decided to head to bed too. The next day, I threw the dirt in. However, even though the door opened, we would hit a trigger while falling that wouldn't let us go down. You can't go down there yet. So we did what any logical players would do, and we stacked 80 boats on top of each other to try and teleport through the trigger when we go in the boat. When this didn't work, we tried to fishing rod the top boat up, but we still couldn't reach through the trigger. No, dude, that was so close! This is when we decided to pair an elytra with the fishing rod, which are both items we could obtain. This would make sure our legs wouldn't hit the trigger before we could reach the boat. I got it!
You got it?
I got it.
You're in?
I'm in.
Oh.
And my fraud broke on the same attempt. This strategy still wasn't consistent enough for us to do mid-game, so I tabbed out to try and think of some strategies until...
I got in. Archroll.
How'd you get in?
I just propelled with the elytra and I got on a boat.
One of these. Like, all the way down here boats.
I got in this exact one I'm in right now.
I can't tell, dude. I'm thinking it has to be... Wait, is there a way to force lag? Like, there's the Planet Lord thing, right? Wait, think if I just go like this. And if I let go. No way.
You just Planet Lorded it?
No way, wow. I just Planet Lorded it. No way. Yeah, so basically right clicking this bar freezes your game. So I jumped on top, froze my game. Then even though my player was floating on the server side, on my side I was falling and already past the trigger. So when I tab back in, I just teleported past it. Now back to the tournament. He is, he's hard carried by Fang.
Oh my god, 7 times and then he teleports off. There ain't no way.
I'm in the vault.
Get him.
Okay. We got this, guys. I then grabbed the best items that hopefully we wouldn't be yelled at for using. Diamond chest plate, take that pot, and then take this offhand weapon. Viv, take this pot. Who's this? Helix, take this pot.
Whoa, final assault!
Alright, let's go, let's all final assault, let's go.
I took it on accident, I dropped it. Let's go.
I'm going. We all final assault.
You wanna take it immediately when we go in?
Yeah, I'm free doing it. Alright, I'm using mine. Idea.
No, it's harder than
I got it. I just killed two people. Yes. After clutching the last game, I got third in the tournament. Throughout, my strategies were constantly being banned, so I didn't do too bad considering I wasn't even playing the objective.
Did any of red team drink a potion called the Final Stand?
Did anyone drink Final Stand?
I feel like someone
drank a potion that I don't think it said Final Stand. Whoa, Final Assault!
The only way they could have looted the vault is to complete the secrets with hacks, and we already caught one of them hacking. That vault is impossible to access. We legit saw Archul speed hacking! Archul wasn't hacking, I think.
But if I don't get all the achievements, then it doesn't count at all. And I'll just stay with my normal score. Because I can get all the achievements in two games.
I think you're being left on red in a voice call.
That's crazy. I'm joining voice call with people.